When it comes to cool new advances, nuclear science has always boasted some of the most far-out discoveries. When the heaviest element found in nature was discovered, the farthest away known planet was Uranus, and so the element was named uranium. By the time an element heavier than uranium was created, there was a new farthest out planet, Neptune, and Neptunium was born. And by the time they discovered an element heavier still, Pluto still held planetary status, and we had plutonium.
Plutonium is a man-made substance. It's an element that, generally speaking, does not exist in nature. It's just stable enough to be something that we can keep around, but it's also just unstable enough that you can use it inside a nuclear bomb. It's really tricky metal, probably appropriately named plutonium for Pluto, originally the planet, but also the Roman god of death.
Plutonium is prone to both chemical and physical changes with shifts in temperature, and it's both radioactive and toxic. What's more, it's pyrophoric, meaning it can catch fire when it's exposed to air.
Glenn Seaborg, when he discovered it, gave it the atomic abbreviation of PU, not PL, and it was partially as a joke because plutonium is so difficult and somewhat nasty to work with, so it's PU.
Of course, plutonium was essential to the wartime bomb effort, and despite its challenges, it continues to find useful applications today, such as fueling space exploration vehicles like the Curiosity rover sent to Mars. After all these years, plutonium is still one far-out element.